My name is Eric Sheptak, and I am the chairman of a group called SHARC, SHARC with a C, that stands for Shelter, Housing, and Respectful Change. We began meeting in April of 2011 around the budget crisis, and presently, our biggest project is working on the future of the Federal City Shelter, otherwise known as CCNV, which stands for the Community for Creative Nonviolence. And long story short, the future of that shelter is in limbo right now. There's a task force, which is headed by Councilman Jim Graham, who was here earlier, which is talking about the future of that property and all of its residents. And like Linda told you to get involved, well, we can get involved in that, because when that is done, we will succeed at housing one-fifth of D.C.'s homeless community. And that is something that D.C. government has not been able to do. We have people in D.C. government making six figures a year. We have people that have made almost $1 million since they pledged to end homelessness here in D.C. And yet, the number of homeless has gone up. Now, that, of course, is bad news. And there's more bad news, which is that when I started coming to these vigils every year, we had 100 people a year dying while homeless. Now, the good news is that number has gone down. Last year, it was only 43. This year, last I heard, it was 20-some-odd people. 26? Okay, so it's at 26 now. And so the number is going down. That much is good, but I think we can all agree that even one homeless death is one too many, okay? And so we have to get down to where nobody is dying homeless, and we have to keep increasing the pressure until we get to that point. Now, I heard some more good news earlier concerning the weather. You know, this is really warm for December. Some folk complain about global warming, but if this is the result, I'll take it, you know. I got no problem with it. You know, those of you who fight for a green earth, and those of you who fight for an end to homelessness, you know, we're like natural enemies, because we love the warm weather, because less people freeze, you know, and that's good that, you know, we're decreasing the number of deaths. But that said, we talked about solutions, and Graham talked about right thinking. Well, right thinking is that at the end of the day, what we all want is affordable housing and living wage jobs, and for everybody who can't work to be helped however they need to be helped, so that we all have suitable, safe, affordable housing. At the end of the day, that's what we all want, right? All right. Is that all you got? Okay. Okay. So that said, you know, I should also point out that while we talk about the economic inequality, which Pastor Na addressed so well, while we talk about all of the different injustices here, as we talk about how homeless people get beaten and killed just because they're homeless sleeping outside, and some crazy teenager had nothing better to do than to kill a homeless person on a bench. Let's also remember that here in D.C. we had our own case like that. We had Yoshio Nakata, a Japanese immigrant who had his head bashed in on Christmas Eve of 2008 as he slept near the Watergate complex. So it's really close to home for us. But let's also remember, you know, that we do need to come out and get more involved. It is very difficult to get people, homeless people, to get involved in solving their own problem. Now, I try not to say too much about myself when I make speeches, but let me tell you that when two ladies walked to the Franklin School shelter in June 2006 and told myself and 239 other men about the impending closure of that shelter, for me it was a no-brainer. When they said, what do you want to do? Do you want to get involved? It was a no-brainer. I just jumped right in and said, where do I sign? And I've been involved ever since. Now, not everybody decides just that quickly, but I would hope that you would want to be involved in a problem that directly affects you. I would hope that you'd want to solve the various problems of your society, even if you're not directly affected, that you would care about your neighbors. You know, but we need to get that fire in us, and we need to get to a point where we give those folk over there a headache, and the folk down the road there a headache, until they meet our demands. We need to not let up, okay? You got to have that fire in your belly. You got to get to the point where you can't just walk past the problem and not do anything about it. You know, a couple of years ago, there was a Mexican immigrant in New York who was homeless, and he saw a woman being robbed. So he went up, I believe his name was Alfredo Talayax, and he saw a woman being robbed, and he ran up to help her. Well, she got away, and he got fatally stabbed in the process. So he ran a few yards and collapsed, and he died on the sidewalk. And there was a video, security video, showing 25 people walking past him as he lied there on the sidewalk dying. And they did nothing to help him. They did nothing to save him. Had somebody done something soon enough, he could have been saved. He could have been here with us today. But he was homeless, and he saw fit to help somebody else. But when he got stabbed, nobody saw fit to help him. Because we as a society have gotten to a point where we say, that's not my problem. You know, tell somebody else. You let them fix it. But we need to get that out of our system, and we need to get that fire in our belly that causes us to say, every problem is my problem. An injury to one is an injury to all. And I'm going to go into the halls of Congress, and I'm going to go into the Wilson Building, and I'm going to go down to the White House, and I'm going to give them a headache, and I'm going to be a human hemorrhoid, just like Eric Sheptock, until they meet our demands, until we have affordable housing, until we have living wage jobs, until everybody, even those who cannot work, are guaranteed housing. And the last thing I'll say before I go is that, you know, while we talk about all this, we should also bear in mind, not only are we the wealthiest country in the world, but we are also very technologically advanced. And technology, even Obama has admitted that technology is taking away a lot of jobs. You know, so when you go into CVS and you have the self-checkout, right. You know, remember, that's taking a lot of people's jobs away. Right. That's putting a lot of people in the unemployment line. That's putting a lot of folk in the homeless shelter. Okay? And so, at the end of the day, that is the crux of the problem, is that we have become so modernized, so technologically advanced, that machines are replacing people, and those people are becoming unemployed, you know, and corporations are all about their bottom line, not about the people who work for them, not about helping folk, not about employing folk and making sure that we can all get along, but just about their bottom line. And that's what it's all come down to, is we're a capitalist society. It's really all about the money, and we need to get over that too. But with that, I'm going to hand off the mic, because as you probably guessed, I can talk for a long time.